Hey everybody, welcome to another Aqua's Adventure, of course, on my Minecraft world. So today we're going to be hopefully having a lot of fun. We're going to be working on some projects, destroying a couple projects, just kind of sad. But before we do anything, I'm just going to slide my mouse over here and show you guys this. Yeah, I'm not going to explain this, just to leave you guys in suspense. I'm not even going to explain it. Let's just go over to my house, or the base, and I've got a little list of things. You guys know, almost every episode, I have like a little list of things that I want to get done. So let's go over here. Today, one of our plans is to finish the chessboard, maybe. I don't even know if we're going to do that. We got to take down the fishing farm, because in the 1.11 update, it actually broke. I did go into the end. I got more elytra. I got 2 dragon heads, a lot of shulker chests, and a lot of building blocks. So I got 2 dragons head here from like the little dungeon things. I've got a lot of shulker boxes. Actually, I have like 15 of them, but they're at the build site over there, which you guys don't even know about because I haven't even talked about it. And then we got, of course, some building blocks. And I got 2 more elytra wings, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I got 2 more. Yeah, so that is pretty cool. We are starting a skyscraper, I'll talk about that in a second, and spawn tunnel entrance that we built. So you guys know our spawn point is over that way, and we built a tunnel all the way there with rail tracks, but I never did anything with it thus far. I do want to build that tunnel, but what I did start off camera is the entrance. So, as you can see, this is like kind of the entrance to it. And then if we go in, the tracks go. So this is what we have at the moment. There's just nothing on the walls anywhere. And it's just like a straight line. So I just started. This is how the tunnel will look like all the way through. And then this is the entrance. And I will have an entrance on the other side somewhere. But yeah, guys, look at this tower. Wow. All right. And I'm going to have to talk more about it. I'm going to have to explain what I was thinking, what I was doing, why I didn't build any of it on camera. And it's nowhere near done, by the way. But yeah, I can just kind of take a look at it. It's crazy. Alright, so let's take down a few things. We talked about that. So, the skyscraper. You guys know... You know what? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to go over to the skyscraper. I'll start doing work on it, and then I'll talk about it while I start work. So, what I've done so far is just obviously built the walls. I've built all 4 sides around, and then I've added glass. You'll see it once we get closer. What I still haven't done is added the wooden floors in, and I'll have to tell you guys about that. But yeah, this is a giant skyscraper. So on a modded server me and my friends are playing on, my friend has a tendency to build skyscrapers, and I've always loved building skyscrapers. In all my other worlds, I end up building one or two skyscrapers, and I decided this world needs to have one. So off camera, I dug out, you guys know, from like all the way over there, all the way here, you can even see like the land cut out. This was a dense forest, so I cleared out all the land, I took down all the trees, and I've set down the base. And guys, just for reference, this goes all the way to sky limit. This is the highest you can go. And yeah, so obviously, what I did first is I built the walls. This was a solid brick wall all the way up, all on 4 sides, and I punctured holes and then added the glass. And if we go inside real quick, I removed the floor obviously because that's what we got to add in. But yeah guys, it's pretty big. It's not a small building, like there's a good bit of size. And then I think each floor is 6 blocks tall, and there's a lot of floors. Look at this. I think there's over 20 to 30 floors in here. And I built a one deep wide little thing, because that's where I had to put the windows in. So I made a one wide thing with a ladder, and I put the windows in. So what today we're going to be working on is adding the floor. And to get the floor, I need a bunch and a bunch of spruce wood. And one double chest full, and then we got a little bit here. You guys want to know, how did you get so much spruce wood? Well, if you guys remember, right where I'm walking used to be a dense spruce forest. Everything over there, everything here, all the way back there, all the way around, even over there, all of this, like, see how thick that is? It used to be this thick all the way around. I think I spent only gathering wood about 6 hours, only gathering wood. Building just the stone bricks, I probably spent another 6 to 8 hours. Putting in the glass, I probably spent another 4 hours. And then probably putting in these little side thingy panels, I probably spent a good 2-3 hours. Like, guys, I've been working on this for almost close to a week now, almost every single day for a couple hours. Like, this isn't a joke. I don't know how small it looks on camera, but this thing ain't small. This thing is gigantic. But yeah, I don't know if I missed anything. And yeah, really what I was doing is I was hopping in, like, Discord, or it's like a TeamSpeak type thing, if you guys don't know what it is, with my friends. We've been playing games, and while, like, in queue for League of Legends or something, I've been doing this, or just when I'm bored. And yeah, guys, it is a skyscraper, and I don't know why I built it over here. I guess it was the only available spot, kind of. I kind of wanted to build it somewhere where we can see it from a lot of places. And then my mouse pad is, like, all jumbled. Anyway, and with the nice thing about this is I cleared out all the spruce wood, obviously, here. This is really nice because this clears out all this land for us to build more stuff. So now we're going to... because a lot of this land's already taken up. So now we're going to have to kind of expand towards this way. And yeah, guys, I just cleared out the first kind of block so we can start putting floors in. But yeah... each one of these is gonna need wood on it, and this is gonna be literally crazy. So, I think how many? This is gonna involve a lot of spruce wood. Like, a lot of spruce wood. Let's see. Oh, and I'm already running out of room. Oh, gosh. Oh, I need those ender pearls. Let's put a couple in there. Yeah, I think I'll have enough spruce wood. That was like a little dent in here. So yeah, what I'm going to have to go do. And also, the one trouble I'm going to have is lighting. But honestly, I'm worrying about the lighting later on. So for now, guys, most of this build is off camera. But I do want to do some of it on camera, obviously, so it just doesn't pop up. It already felt like it just popped up. This entire thing was built completely off camera. Last episode... none of this was here. It completely wasn't here. That's the thing, is like, I kind of feel bad for not showing you guys the building process. But at the same time, I just wasn't in the mood for recording at the time, so I just kind of built it. But hopefully you guys like this. Of course, it's going to get better and better. We got to light it up. We got to add the floors. We're going to add decorations. It's going to be a lot of fun. Of course, this ladder is going to go away. We're going to add like a stairwell. This is going to be kind of like an office building. Now, I kind of want to nickname it the Trump Tower, but I don't know if I should. I don't think I will. But, yeah, I'm just going to build a kind of like a business tower, which is going to be kind of fun. So, guys, I'm not going to talk through this because this will take probably a good, I don't know, about a couple hours. But it's going to take quite a bit. So, yeah, I'll be right back in a couple hours. Okay, guys, so I built the first floor here, and yeah, I think the entire building is going to look nice, but here's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to build the entire thing now. I think it's a better decision to. In this episode, I introduced you to the new skyscraper. I showed you all the wood. And I think I'm going to do the rest of the building off camera, just like how I built it. This is going to take several hours. It's not going to get done now. So, guys, next episode, I'll probably have it done by then, because, of course, I don't upload these very often, probably once every couple weeks. But, yeah. Okay, I thought something was messed up. I'm like, what's going on here? Sure, it's something with the light. But, anyway, yeah. Now, the one thing that we have to do is we actually have to take down a farm. I never said which one, but I'll give you a hint. That's the one I'm standing by. The fishing farm in this update is now broken. Could even try to prove it to you guys. It's a super nice farm. I built it. It looks all cool. But it is actually broken. If we test it here. See, if you guys see. Now the thing doesn't stay in there. It just kind of comes back. And it can't fish that way. So, the farm is sadly broken, actually. Yep, it feels bad because this farm was, like, super useful and it got us a ton of stuff. But, here's the thing. There is new things to build. Like, there's other fishing farms, which we will build in the upcoming episode. So, not now. But what I'm going to do is I'm obviously not going to destroy it. I mean, look, guys, look at this stuff that it got us. It's crazy. And I think we got enough stuff to tide us off. But here's the thing. I'm not going to just destroy it, the entire thing. What I'm going to do is I'm probably just going to take down, like, the innards of it. So, you know, I'm probably going to need a chest. Now, you know what? We'll just take it down. Oh, no. Okay, so let's get rid of this water block. There we go. Yeah, like, a lot of stuff like the redstone we're going to take down. Sadly, this farm is now broken. Very sad, but, oh no, I need to place this in there. I still want to keep the actual building itself, so when we build a new fishing farm, we'll at least either have this built here, or we could remodel it after this. But yeah, actually, probably shouldn't get rid of that. I'll keep all the chests and stuff in here. Yep. So sad. I really liked this farm. But it's okay. And even this stuff. Okay, I don't know. So I think we might just leave it like this. All the redstone ripped out. We'll just leave some of the chests here. Yeah, I think that'll be good. Because, again, I still want to use the building. So I'll leave that there. I might have to obviously reconstruct the building and stuff. And you know what we'll do? This kind of goes back into the system. So we'll just drop all this stuff here. So we can get rid of it. But yeah, guys, the fishing farm is officially closed down and broken. Alright, so a couple things that I don't think were worth putting on the signs. Obviously, I did a lot of playing around, so with that, like, I breeded a bunch more. With this, like, XP, I have obviously mending on my stuff. I, like, fixed my tools and stuff, which is nice. You know, I could even maybe show you. So one cool thing about this new, I think it was like a couple updates ago, is that obviously you could dual hand, I don't know how to call it, but anyway, it says the mending enchantment, meaning if I ever gain any XP, it fixes a tool. So if we jump in here and start breeding animals, obviously when they breed, it gives us XP, and it's a pretty good amount of XP too. So now whenever I pick up this XP, it actually fixes my tool. So you guys can see it. It's actually fixing my tools as we speak. And again, literally one run through this sheep pile will completely fix my tool. And this is a diamond tool. And this will last me for a good amount of time. And remember, it fixes it completely. So in a way, I do have an unlimited supply of the tool. Obviously, I just got to be careful not to break it. And we literally have these tools forever. You got to remember, this is like efficiency 5, silk touch, unbreaking 3, mending or unbreaking. So it's a nice tool. And you know, I'll actually fix up my axe here fully. And you know what? Now I'll jump into the cows since it looks like I breeded most of them. So I'll go ahead and jump in here real quick. And fix my tool all the way. It's taking forever. But and then again, I think this is a good price to pay. Like a couple minutes in the pit to fix my tool almost completely. I think that's even good. Alright, so yeah. Just wanted to show you guys right there how to fix your tools if you truly need it. You know, let's just stick stuff in this chest. And I need my axe. There we go. Okay, cool. So yeah, that's another thing I've been kind of doing. Oh yeah, guys. And one thing I didn't say about the skyscraper yet. Obviously, in the skyscraper, there was a ton of glass and a ton of bricks involved. I did not say where I got those from. Well, the glass, you guys know a couple episodes we built a portal to the desert, so I went there and collected a couple inventory fulls of sand, brought it back, and the stone, well, obviously, a bunch of episodes ago, we built this, like, industrial smelter right here, and I probably still have a ton. Alright, no, there's not too much in here, but anyway, I think I filled each of these, like, chests up almost halfway full with stone, and then what I did is I put the haste 2 effect on here with efficiency 5 pick, and I went all the way down, and I just did a lot of mining, I mean a lot of mining, and we did get enough materials, which is very nice. Here's some more of my main tools. Anyway, so we started the skyscraper, that is out of the way. Next up, we took down the fishing farm. Alright, and alright, so this is gonna be our last project of the day. I know we didn't do too much, but it was more of just the stuff that I did off camera. But we're going to finish the chessboard. So here, I'll take you guys over to the chessboard, and then we'll start getting work on it. So if you guys remember, I think it was 2 or 3 episodes ago, we started a chessboard. We built the actual board itself, but we never actually... You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go grab my leech real quick. Oh, another thing, I don't know if I showed you guys, but I also went to the end and gathered and farmed a lot of more ender pearls because that's something I was running low on. Alright, so let's head over to the building. You know what I'm going to do, guys? I'm going to show you the chessboard, but I'm going to give you a higher up view of the chessboard from the top of the tower. Because we actually haven't gone to the top of the tower. I haven't showed you guys how tall it is from the top of the tower. So this is going to be a long climb all the way up. Alright, we are at the top now. You guys can look down. This is a pretty tall tower here. And it's even up to par up with, like, the roller coaster. Oh, I thought I was falling. I got scared for a minute there. It's even up to par with, like, the roller coaster up there. It's the actual mob farm is under us. And, yeah, you can kind of see the entire world. It's just kind of cool. You can see the entire world from here. There's our entire base. And then there's the castle we're going to build. Yeah, there's the ice farm. We haven't gone to the ice farm in a while. But right below us is the chessboard. So yeah, we built the entire chessboard, but we didn't build the pieces on it. But now what we're going to do, let's place some elytra on. Let's give a small flight around the world here. I'll give you guys an elytra tour. So this is all the forest that I cleared out. This is where we're going to build the castle. These are all of our pixel arts. There's the horse track, the parkour map, or the battle arena, our main base, the cactus farm, the maze, the little vacation way, the arrow game, the cactus farm. Oh no, the animals, and hopefully we even make it. I don't think we even make it to chessboard. I flew a little too low. Anyway, so let's take that off, put that back on. So yeah, this is our chessboard, and now we gotta build the chess pieces. So I'm gonna go gather some materials, get some reference to how they look like, and we'll be right back. Okay guys, so I think the best option to go with here is since the actual keyboard, it's not a keyboard, the chessboard itself is black and white. I don't want to have black and white pieces. So what we're going to actually do is we're going to make kind of like a wooden chessboard. We're going to have birch pieces for the white, and we're going to have dark oak for the black pieces. So I think that's how we're going to do it. So let's go ahead, break a couple of these open. Okay, so let's head over to the chessboard. And what my plan right now is we're going to build each pieces, but we're going to build the pieces at the same time. So first, we are going to build all the pawns. If you don't know where the pawns are, for each set, obviously, if you guys don't know how chess works, in the beginning, there's obviously two players, one on this side, one on this side. One is black, one is white. The first row here is filled with like all kinds of pieces. The second row is all pawns. And of course, for the side that starts here, this first row is a bunch of full of pieces, and the second is full of pawns. And obviously, I don't know the names of these because I say them weird. Obviously, it's the king, queens, knights, and yeah, there's a bunch of cool pieces. But first, we're going to build, since the most, like, the one with the most pieces is the pawns, because each side is like a full lane of pawns. So real quick, I'm going to look up how that looks. Alright guys, so the pawn is like the most simple and easiest to build, so it shouldn't be hard. So kind of how they look, and I'll probably even put the pictures on screen for reference here. Oh no, I fell off. Okay, let's just take... I guess I'll just use birch to climb up. So how they look like, again, you'll see it on screen, is kind of... We'll start with the white side. So this side's going to be white. They kind of have like a small base. And by the way, how this is going to go, since each of these is 5x5, each piece is going to be kind of 3x3. So pawns are going to look, they have obviously a base, then they have a little, like, neck, kind of. And then, I don't know how we're going to build this, really, because, again, this is kind of like a small perimeter to build it on, but I guess we could build them something like that. So these are, it looks kind of weird. So that could be kind of like a pawn, because they have, like, kind of the base and the single kind of like thin neck, and then they kind of have a bulb. And again guys, if this looks terrible, I might like off camera or something come by and fix each piece. Again, this is kind of just the first rendition of the pieces, so we'll see how it looks overall. But here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna finish the rest of the pawns. Okay, so that is both the pawns for each side done. So this lane is entirely black pawns and then white pawns. So now we're going to have to build each piece the special type of pieces. So, the rook, knight, bishop, king, queen, knight, bishop, rook. Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna go kind of completely freehand here. So let's do one of the rooks on each side. So there's a rook here and then the rook on the other edge. So let's start obviously with a flat base. Let's go one up. And the pawns are usually the shortest piece, so we're going to make the rest of them a little bit taller. So let's add something like this. And then if we go one more up, and then add one more base. Okay, somehow we're going to have to. Let's jump up here. Get rid of that one. Then the rooks kind of have like a little... They look like a little fortress wall, kind of like over at my castle. So kind of have like a little dent thing going on. Let's see how that looks. And again, they have to be a little bit taller than the pawn, so I have to kind of make them tall. Let's try to do this. And I think it would be good, actually. Honestly, that looks like a rook. It kind of does. Well, you know what? Again, guys, this is like the first draft. If I can find something that looks better, I will change it. So let's build the other rook here. Is that, and then place little corner bits. So that is the rooks for each side. All right. Next, we got the knights. Now, the knights are interesting. So let's go ahead and prototype, I guess. Let's go ahead and build the base. And then I think we're going to build this. We're going to go one up, just like that. And then I think I know. Because a knight kind of looks like, again, everything is on the screen. Kind of looks like a little horse piece. So if we go like that. Alright, guys. So once again, this looks actually garbage. But I will fix it in the future, so it's fine. I will fix it in the future. And of course, there's one of these on each side. Now, this is going to be a little bit tougher to build because I made it all complicated. But this is probably definitely one of the pieces that I'm going to have to go ahead and, after this episode, probably rebuild because it looks terrible. Okay, guys, so all four of the knights are now done. So next piece in line is the bishop. So that is a piece, obviously. I don't even know what I'm saying. So let's see, how are we gonna do this one? This one kind of looks like a priest kind of thing. So let's prototype it. Let's build the base. And let's just say, let's bring it up like this. And let's just kind of say it has like a kind of big top hat on. Actually, I think this is gonna be pretty good. And then let's just make it have like a hat on. Let's go ahead and like finish off its little bulb on top. Honestly, I don't think that's a bad design, kind of. But even if it is bad, I'll go over it later. Let's just build the rest of them. So of course there's four of these, two on that side, two on the other. So real quickly, I'm gonna go ahead and build these real quick. Alright, so that is all four of the bishops built. Now all we have is the king and the queen. The king, the piece that controls the game, whether you lose or you die, and the queen, the most powerful in the game. So let's just say, I'm trying to look at a picture here. If we're looking from this side, the king and then queen, and then that's the opposite. Okay. So, how are we going to do this? The king goes on this side. So let's build the king. How about we build the king and queen taller than all of the other pieces? Obviously, they're the two most important. So let's make them thicker. Just like that. And then we got one base, or the second base, so-called. Now let's build a third base. And then for a lot of games, the king is kind of pictured as having like kind of like a cross on his head. So Let's go ahead and build like a little cross. Let's see how that looks. That honestly doesn't look bad. Maybe we, let's see if we add a little corners on the end here. Yeah, honestly, I really like that piece actually. So what we're gonna do, let's go to the other side and we're gonna build the exact same thing. Oh, no, that's not it. Oh, okay, I messed up both of them, all right. We got one down there and one down there, and there we go, that is the second king. Cool. And now all we need is the queen. So now I'm gonna have to find a way to represent the queen because the rook already took the kind of crown look because it's like a siege tower building kind of piece. Alright, so let's start out with the same kind of formula as we did with the king. So let's build a double base. Let's build, I guess we can just do it kind of like almost the exact same thing. Add the corner pieces. And then, wait, did I add a corner piece? No, okay, so add the corner pieces. Have a base. And somehow we're going to have to represent this as the queen. So you could tell it's the king by the cross on the top. Now we're going to have to build the queen in a way where we can tell that it is the queen. Wonder if we can put, like, a heart on top somehow. Like a miniature heart. How about we bring it out? So I don't want it to go past the boundaries of this. How about this? What does this look like? And also just kind of a circle. You know what? That looks like the queen. Alright, you know what? That's fine. That doesn't... I kind of made that up on my own. But I think it'll work. And again, as for like the fifth time, if these look completely ugly, don't worry. They'll probably even end up changing by literally next episode. Bishop, put a little pointy hat. Another little pointy hat. Alright, cool. So that is the chessboard technically done. Now, again, for the millionth time, I might switch some things up. What I might even do is like maybe take the bases all out and replace it with something else. But yeah, technically that is it done. So real quickly, let's go to sleep so we can get some daylight out. And we don't have the elytra. I think I put it back. Oh no, that's fine. Alright, well, we can kind of take a look at the chessboard. So at least it looks like a chessboard. We got all the pieces. I can't really see it that well, but it's okay. You guys might be thinking, what are you doing? Well, there's water under me, so it's okay. Let's kind of take a look at it while we're falling. So it doesn't, okay, it doesn't look terrible. It doesn't look terrible, guys. So in the end today, to sum it up, we've taken down the fish farm, or the fishing farm. We've finished the chessboard. We technically worked on the skyscraper, but it was more of showing you guys. And yeah, it's just, we've built the tunnel over there, which is very exciting. So gonna go on F5, F1 here, guys. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully you guys had a lot of fun watching. I know I had a lot of fun playing today. And if you did, make sure to like and comment as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.